Now obviously we want to put a new line on each of these, just so it's actually readable in a nice way. And then, because this is our main method, we want to just return no error code. So at this point we can save and we can try running. And lo and behold, we get a build error. Would you like to continue and run? No. So what we have here is quite an obscure error. Unresolved external symbol main referenced in function, and then tmain crt startup, which certainly isn't anything we've written. So what could unresolved external symbol main mean? Well, it probably means that there's something wrong with the main method, and in this case what it's telling us is that the main method cannot be found. The reason for this is that I've called main with a capital M. If we reduce this to lowercase, run again, yes, build. Program runs. So we can see now, we can test it. So please enter your name. Please enter your total savings to date, say 1,000. And your interest rate, well, we'll say 10%. And number of years, we'll call it 1. Interesting, our program didn't display any output. If you've got any idea why, you might realize that it's because at no point do we break here. Now, if we simply use our trusty system pause, program will stop. Can run it again. Same input. So here we go. Input savings are 1,000. Interest earned after a year is 100. New value of savings is 1,100. This is good, but it wouldn't actually pass this assignment because this assignment asks you. The program will then ask the user if they want to run another calculation and respond accordingly. So rather than system pause, what we want to do here is take an input. Would you like to run again? Now, you'll remember our trusty getch method. Whoops, let's call this char getch. Very helpful when we just want to get one result. Oops, capitalization counts. And here, we'll have our output. So if C input equals, and remember, you don't write statements like this, because absolutely not. This will set C input to Y. And while we're at it, we'll test for lowercase, just to be a bit more user-friendly. If we get to here, we want to run again. Now, obviously this will require us to rewrite the program. So in this case, however, we want to quit, so we can return zero. So you might be thinking, how are we going to go back to the beginning of the program? Well, the answer is not something called go to, and if anyone ever tells you to use go to, tell them that they're wrong. Instead, what we want to do is enclose everything here in a loop. For now, I'll just put for while true. Down here, close this off. Now, of course, all the formatting is slightly messed up. Just tab that out. So instead of doing something here specifically, what we want to do is continue with our loop. Alternatively, we want to break from the loop. And if we break from the loop, we return zero. So would you like to run again? Now, if the user enters yes, the program will continue. But if they enter any other key, the program will stop. So we might want to print a message. Just for our sake when we're testing. So we can see that it works. You'd probably remove this line if you were submitting this assignment. So if we look back at the wording of the assignment, the program will then respond accordingly. Now, you might say, in fact, that you don't want to quit if the user enters an invalid key like F or a number, in which case this should become C input equals N, or lowercase version of N. We break. Otherwise, we want to tell them to enter new input. How can we do that? Again, through the use of a loop. Our problem is, if we put a loop here, I'm sure you can see, we'll no longer be able to continue or break out of the outer loop, only this inner one. So how can we get around this? Well, if we move our C input variable out here, oops, we'll know that it actually persists, so we can check it after we get out of this loop. So all we need to do is move this code out here, and instead of all this, we say if C input equals y, lowercase y, n, uppercase n, lowercase n, etc. If that's the case, sorry, just put that into one line. If that's the case, we do want to break. Okay, so this will take us out of our, this will take us out of this while loop, and we'll know that the value of C input when we get to here is one of these, and so we don't have to worry about the program running forever. And if we get past this break statement in the if, we know that they've entered an invalid key. Please enter Y or N. So now we can go ahead and test all this. Checking for some compile errors. None. Excellent. Please enter your total savings to date. Yes, well, that's 1,000. So interest rate, we can do 10 again. Number of years, 1 year, etc. Would you like to run again? So what happens if I press J? Please enter Y or N. Would you like to run again? Type Y. Now we see that we've got a bug. Please enter your name. Please enter your total savings date. This is because we need to call rewind. And the place we'll want to call rewind, if we stop debugging, is going to be before we loop through again. So we can do it here. This should do it. Number of years, one, judge runner in. Yes, please enter your name, Bob. Total savings state is 2,000, interest rate 5. Number of years, one, 2,100. Would you like to run again? No. Goodbye, press any key to continue. And that's pretty much it then. We've probably solved our assignment. We can just double check. Create an interest calculator. Program should take a user's name, savings, and savings account interest. Yes, we've done all this. And calculate how much interest they'll earn. We've done that. Then respond accordingly after displaying the output and see if they want to run another calculation. So yes, there you go. That is a 60 nearly line program. Very simple. Now what I'd suggest you do is you take this assignment. If you can think of an interesting way to modify it, go ahead and modify it and see if you can go through this process yourself after watching the video, see how much you remember. Of course, if you've got any questions, feel free just to post them below and I'll get back to you. Thank you.